evening to our esteemed viewers out there, and a very warm Merry Christmas to you all. You're welcome to yet another edition of your favorite weekly news magazine program, Sunday Digest. This week promises to be entertaining and yet informative as we bring you stories as concerns Biafra State and Nigeria at large. Lined up for our viewing pleasure is a report of a former aide to the NDDC MD, Judge Turner, who faced legal battles with the EFCC for over 7 years. He came out victorious and he has taken to the altar of God in thanksgiving. We'll also be bringing you details of the importance as by the benefit of praising God. How often do you say thank you to the creator of the heaven and earth? Our correspondent is standing by and she'll be bringing you details of the benefits of praising God often. And also, we'll also be bringing to your viewing pleasure sight and sound of a former of the wedding ceremony of a former control staff of NTA Yenagoa, Frank Dressman, and his hat robe, who got weathered over the weekend. And also, an assistant manager of the news department of NTA Yenagoa, Prezi, laid to rest his mother in Turbane, Brutu local government area of Bayelsa State. We'll be bringing you details of all these reports and many more and Sunday Digest this week. But first, I'll take you through the new segment of today's program. I remain back to pray away. Praising God is one important activity that God demands from man, especially his children, as he inhabits the praises of his people according to the Bible. Considering the importance of praising God, which many churches and believers in Christ make part of worship, correspondent on special assignment unravels the different ways and benefits of praising God. Charity James reports.
To praise God means to exalt, reverence, thank, and worship God alone. It is a way of expressing happiness for what God did and even what we expect Him to do. But it starts with right understanding of God and who He is. Praises is also seen to be one thing God will not do for Himself, but expect man to do for Him.
Praises come from the heart. If that praise does not come from the heart, it does not ascend to the throne.
Although some praises to God often involves quietness, but most times it is always expressive. While some people choose to praise God through prayers, songs, and instruments, others choose giving of testimonies, kneeling and dancing, among others, as their own way of praising God.
One thing he knows that he does that he didn't do for himself, which is praising himself. And he has created man in his own image to praise him. That is just number one of it. Praising him by singing songs to him, by giving him things with his thanksgiving.
I sing holy praise songs. I dance. Sometimes I go on my knees. Sometimes I lay on my bed. I roll. Sometimes I'll be walking on the way. Unknowingly, sometimes if I think of the past, I'll just say, God, I thank you.
I have dance. I sing by sowing seed, by giving offerings.
Although there is no specific way to praise him, what is certain is that praising God attracts enormous blessings to those who are involved in praising God.
When you praise God, God will alleviate you, because when praises goes up, blessings come down. Then number two, it also attracts blessings also. Then three, when you praise God, get supernatural protection.
One thing about the enemy is to make you weak, being depressed. But when you praise God, that depressed force in you will exactly go off, and when it repels it, you become a joyful sight of the Lord. When you praise him, you know that you have upliftment within even you, both in physical body and in the spiritual body.
God preserves us, and we have financial breakthrough, and things we are praying for, we also receive answers.
Every Christian owes God praises, and it is good to praise God, as it is said that prayers move mountain while praises move God. in Yenagoa. Charity James, NTA News.
Family members, friends and well wishers joined the former aide to the NDDC Managing Director, Judge Turner, to appreciate God for his mercies and victory over 7 years of legal battles with the EFCC. Darius Akumoye has details.
It was a time of sober reflection, but with thanksgiving to God Almighty for his love and victory in times of challenges and the life of evangelist Allah George Turner and his family. The celebrant during the 2023 annual harvest of Christian Church of God Mission recounted his ordeal in the hands of the EFCC, who prosecuted him for 23 count charges at the Federal High Court, Port Harcourt. George Turner said the victory, despite all odds, came from God when all hope was lost. He appreciated the former President Goodluck Jonathan, Governor of Bayelsa State Doye Diri, and others who stood by him during his days of trial.
23 count charge. For the court to carefully review everything and say that they failed to prove even one against me. I think it calls for some kind of reflection. The EFCC and indeed sister agencies should learn to be prosecutors and not persecutors.
But today, we give God all the glory. I came here with my wife, with my constituents, to thank this big God who has helped, marvelously helped, our brother. And by reason of the judgment of the court, Justina has been cleared with all the misgivings.
Former Deputy Governor, Chief of Staff Government House, Assembly members, commissioners and friends, thank God for victory for George Turner and his family.
It's a learning process. You don't see man, you don't see the issues or the natural issues that were used to cause the storm in your life. Just know that God has seen you through. Learn lessons and become a better person.
Who, by the grace of God, was accused of several things, and by the Lord's making, he was vindicated in the court because he is still at the age. At the age, you know, with so much potentials to go along with life.
If you want to solve your problem without putting God first, for sure you surely not succeed. So it's to hand over all that is happening to you, be it good or bad, to God. And when you believe in God, you live a stressless life. But Judge Turner, I'm 100% sure he trusted in God and God came to his rescue.
It's one of the most fulfilled days of the Ogbia Kingdom. For those that are here and those that are not here, everybody is happy. And for me, as a person, the young man happens to be one of my products. And so I'm one of the freest because he's free.
Chairman on the occasion and Commissioner for Health, Dr. Pabra Newtini-Gweli, charged the celebrant not to be deterred, but to continue to remain focused to enable him achieve his dreams, describing his trial and resilience as experience for young leaders to learn and emulate.
Leadership of this nation truly lies in the hands of the young people. And for a young man who was given an opportunity to serve in a position to learn under great leaders, and he was blackmailed because he was saying people saw his future, where he was going to. They blackmailed him to ensure that young people shouldn't have a place in the affairs of leadership in this nation. But today, God has proven us right that the destiny of this nation is in the hands of young people.
High point of the ceremony was a special thanksgiving by George Turner and his family, friends, as well as prayers for his family. The harvest had harvesters who sow in the vineyard of the Lord. In Yenagoa, Doris Akomonye, NTA News.
Poor parenting and lack of early training of children in a godly way have been identified as some of the causes of high rates of crime and other social vices in society. For this reason, the need to raise a godly generation that fears the Lord has been emphasized. Charity James, in this report, unravels the roles of parents and church in raising a godly child for a better Nigeria.
Train up a child in a way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. This Bible excerpt is a proof to the fact that raising children in God's way will make them become assets to the family, church, and nation.
You must not be among those wayward children that are aside. Then you must know how to teach other children the same thing that you learn from God.
We should depend on Jesus, that Jesus can save.
We should not say we should obey our parents. Anything our parents tell us, we should do. If they tell us to sit, we sit. If they tell us to stand, we stand.
The reverse seems to be the case in some of the children and Nigerian youths, as the future of some youth who are the next generation are being threatened by many social vices and criminal activities due to poor Christian foundation.
The problem we are facing today is because our children does not know God. If they know God, they will not be doing some of the things they are doing. A child that knows Christ cannot carry gun to rob on the street. A child that knows God cannot stand on the street to become a prostitute. It's because these children do not have the fear of.
Although raising godly children is a bit complicated than disciplining them, clergy say the role of parents and church in this task cannot be overemphasized. According to them, parents and church should collaborate and instill the fear of God into their children by rebuking them when there is need, teach them the word of God, and praying for them at all times.
Raise godly children by supporting them spiritually in prayer and organizing Christian program for them, and also giving them Christian book to read.
The church cannot play this role alone without the effort of the parents, because first of all, it is the parents that bring the children to church. So I will advise that parents should enable to bring their children to church, not just when they have grown, but from the day of dedication. You should start bringing that child to church. And when the child comes to church, it is the responsibility of the church to train the child in the ways of God.
Call to gather your children and to give them a godly advice, because the Bible says that evil communication corrupts good manner.
For parents who miss it in this area of raising godly children, it is not too late. All that is needed to be done is fervent prayers for such children and youths, as God is ever ready to help. In Yenagoa, Charity James, NTA News.
And let's take this time out for a quick break. When we come back, Sunday Digest continues.
Hey children, it's another fun-catching Christmas party. Presents live on TV a Christmas party for children and adults. There will be various kind of games, dancing competition, merry-go-round, lots of fun, and a shout-out live on TV. Children, come meet with Vanny, Dora, Frozen, Batman, Winnie the Pooh, and your special delight, Father Christmas, for your extra gift packages. Date 25th December 2023. Time 12 noon. Venue NTA Yenagoa premises. Gate fee 1000 naira only. Oh yes, 1000 naira only. That comes with your gift packages. Come have the most thrilling Christmas moment live on NTA. It's fun, 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 fun.
Glad to have you back. To some, adultery is one of the worst things that can happen to a marriage, as it violates everything a couple has built. to others, adultery is literally tears that binds of a marriage union. While there may be millions of varied views on the concept of adultery, this report takes a look at the Christian perspective of the act. Ifoma IOJ brings us the details.
Typically, adultery occurs when a married person engages in a sexual relationship with someone else. This, according to the clergy, was never how God intended marriage. It was intended to be a lifetime commitment between one man and one woman, as reflected in the Bible's first marriage of Adam and Eve. To many marriage partners, infidelity, which is fast becoming a norm, hurts like being stabbed in the heart and twisting the blade that never fades without God's supernatural healing. Well, the impact of infidelity is a story for another day. Here, pastors highlight the Christian perspective of adultery.
And the principle of God is that a man should get a wife for himself legally by paying the bride price of the woman. And when that thing is done, it means you marry legitimately. But when someone leaves his legal wife and go outside to sleep with another woman, this is adultery, and God hates it.
The apostle said to avoid sexual immorality, every man should have his own wife. When a man is married, a woman is married, and still seek to have sexual satisfaction outside marriage, is called adultery. And the church, to the church, it is a great sin. The church condemns it.
Thou shalt not commit adultery, says the seventh commandment, while the Old Testament states that a person who commits adultery has no sense, as whoever does so destroys himself.
But it's a sin that is against our own soul and against God. It's a twofold sin. In every area we try to discourage it, because God is a holy God and He expects us to be holy.
It's a sin against God. Once you live that life, you become an enemy of God. The presence of God will leave you.
When lust conceive, it bringeth forth sin. When sin finish, it bringeth forth death. And you look at this adultery. When immediately you commit, you sleep with a woman or a man, the Spirit of God will leave you.
And so we advise that Christians, even not Christians, let the world desist from it. The consequence is great. The Bible condemns it, and the Bible places a heavy curse upon whosoever that takes another man's wife, a woman taking going in with another woman's husband. The Bible places a curse, a generational curse.
Drawing analogy from the Bible, pastors in Yenagoa also warned that indulging in adulterous feelings is equally detrimental to the soul as a real act of infidelity, and both bear the same credence.
Every child of God, as much as he or she can, should try to keep himself away from those sins, because it will hamper one's growth. It will try to distort someone's relationship with God.
It affects our reputations. It affects our image. It shows we are not sanctified. It shows we are not preaching what we are doing. It is a kind of dent to the Christian faith. And so we advise that Christians, even not Christians, let the world desist from it. The consequence is great. The Bible condemns it, and the Bible places a heavy curse upon whosoever that takes another man's wife, a woman taking going in with another woman's husband. The Bible places a curse, a generational curse. Thus, the church condemns it.
What then is the difference between adultery and fornication?
A fornication is between a boy and a girl that is not married. A boy and a girl that is not married, they are maybe into a relationship, and the sex is involved. That is fornication. But adultery is a man that married a woman and leave the woman and go into another man's wife to sleep with. That is adultery.
Sexual affair among the married people, that is adultery. Differentiating from fornication, fornication is still that immoral affair. Fornication, sexual affair, relationship between the unmarried. It occurs among the unmarried, but when it is happening among the married people, it's called adultery.
It is a sin committed by the unmarried and the married. adultery is committed by the married, while the fornication is committed by the unmarried. So both of them has a very bad implication.
However, scripture is consistent in the prohibition against adultery, as it is considered a great sin in the Christendom. Hence, a call for couples to hold marriage in honor and let the marriage bed be undefiled, as the Bible warns that God will judge the sexually immoral and adulterers. In Yenagoa, Ifeoma Aihoji, NTA News.
Indeed, God frowns at adultery, and people should try and do away with that in marriages. The Nigerian Labour Congress and Trade Union Congress, Congress have described as fake reports in some media platforms purportedly signed by the General Secretary of NLC, Secretary General of TUC Comrades Emmanuel Ogbuaja and Nuhu Toro to commence strike tomorrow, Monday, December 18, 2023, across the country. The labor unions want to reassure Nigerians that this notice did not emanate from them, and neither do they have any intention of initiating any strike action this period. They advise Nigerians to ignore the fake notice. It was a celebration of joining together as a couple and a beautiful thing to behold, as Frank Dressman and former Miss Iroswomoye Igoni were joined together as husband and wife after all traditional rites have been concluded. Let's join Gift Ogbe as she brings us details of the celebration of Frank and as they say yes to each other in a traditional way. Her report.
Name of God the Father.
Amen.
And of the Son.
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
No, not just OK.com.
That was a toast to a fruitful marital bliss in honor of Mr. and Mrs. Ayiba Nengefa Dressma. It was a joyful moment for families, friends, and colleagues of the couple as they joined in the celebration after fulfilling all traditional marriage rites.
Yes, wonderful, it's nice, sir. This is the moment we are waiting for. It is right here before us.
For the couple, it was a prayer answered as they channeled their praises to God Almighty.
Getting married to the will of God, it's a desire I've always looked forward to. And I thank God for bringing this day to pass.
I've been looking forward to this day, seriously. Looking forward to this day, planning towards to this day. Finally, is here, and it has been a success all the way. I thank God.
Prayers and blessings were offered to the couple.
I've advised them, you know, accordingly, and I've wished them well that marriage is nobody knows. Nobody's right, nobody's wrong. No matter how wrong you are, no matter how right you are, if you want your marriage to work, it has to be your right and your wrong. Even when the person is wrong, you accepted that the person survived sometime.
I wish them long life and prosperity, that the marriage should last and last and last. They love themselves, that there should be peace, love and unity between them.
My prayer for this couple is that the Lord will bless their union, the union will be fruitful, there will be love, there will be peace. Every ingredient that will make the marriage to be sweet and last, they will receive. In Jesus' name.
I pray for them. God will cover them with the blood of Jesus. No evil shall befall them. Their marriage will be fruitful. They will not see shame. Shame will not see them. They will die young. None of them will die young. And fruitfulness will be their portion. In the name of Jesus.
Highlights of the celebration were the cutting of the cake and the traditional decoration of the couple as a show of love and togetherness.
Three. Yeah. Oh.
In Yenagoa, Gift Ogbe, NTA News.
Marriage is indeed a beautiful thing, and he that finds a wife certainly has found a good thing and obtained favor from the Lord. And also good to see beautiful Dan Steph from staff of NTA Yenagoa there. And that is it for this week for Sunday Digest. Do well to join us next week when we come your way with more entertaining and yet informative stories as it's concerned by our state and Nigeria at large. And don't forget, Christmas is a season to spread love. Ensure you spread love around your family and your neighborhood. Until next week, it's good night from here.